Welcome. Families, friends, teachers, and classmates, welcome to a truly bittersweet moment. We're here to celebrate, of course, but really, the 85 of us up here are here to say goodbye. Goodbye to you, the people we love so much, but also to each other, as we move on to the next chapter of our lives. And it is this chapter, these next 4 years, that concerns me today. Because a couple of weeks ago in this very gym, we seniors were told that these next 4 years, our college years, would be the best of our lives. I know these words were meant well, but I sincerely hope that they're not true. In fact, I hope our years of college and at Park rank among the worst. Not because Park is a bad place, it's certainly not, and not because college should be bad either, but because it would be so terrible if the best year came at 21 or 22, and the next 60 years were a tale of precipitous decline. Now, I think it would be better, notably, if our lives kept improving and our best years came nearer to the end. I'm going to tell a story about a man named Siddhartha, and hopefully the parallels will become clear soon. Siddhartha was born a prince, his father a very rich king, and his father decided to raise him in a walled garden of earthly delights. Siddhartha had infinite food, beautiful women, and only the young, the happy, and the healthy were let in. Siddhartha had no pain or suffering of any kind until he was about our age, and suddenly he became very bored, and he begged his father, please let me out of this place, let me into the city. And after much protesting, his father said, well, okay, you can leave, and he was let into the city with one of the king's attendants. Very soon on his journey, he saw something strange screaming in the road, and he asked the attendant, he said, what is this thing screaming at me in the road? And the attendant said, that man is sick, like other men. And Siddhartha realized that he too one day would be sick. A while later, he saw something else limping towards him. And he asked the attendant, you know, what is this thing limping towards me in the road? And the attendant says, well, that man is old and he's like other men. And Siddhartha realizes that one day he will too be old. And finally, he sees something still in the road, and he asks the attendant, what is this creature still in the road? And the attendant said, that man is dead, as is the fate of all men. And Siddhartha realized that he too would die. All of this overwhelmed him, and he went back to the walled garden, and he sat for months, destroyed. But it was this harrowing experience, this time of pain, that enlightened Siddhartha to the problems of the world and eventually allowed him to become, drumroll please, the Buddha. Buddhist or not, mostly not in this room, I think we can all take a lesson from that story. In order to do great things, one has to encounter risk first. Like Siddhartha, the 85 of us have been raised in Brooklynville's walled garden, and college will likely be similar. We have been shielded from many of the risks of life, our hands held through all of the big decisions we've had to face. And that's appropriate when you're young, but now it is time to go out and to do great things. Many people, on the other hand, think the goal of life is to keep finding walled gardens, to always avoid this, but I think that only provides a superficial happiness. The things in our lives that may, in the end, devastate us most, marriage, kids, difficult careers, pick your poison, can also be the source of the most profound joys. I hope the next 60, 70, 80 years, if you're ambitious, are filled with beautiful moments. Of course I do. But I hope, too, that people turn their backs on us and I hope that projects we spent long hours on fall through. By the end, we should all have failures, sadnesses, and lasting regrets. That would be the real proof we were trying. Thank you, good luck.